Hello and welcome to Live from the Apocalypse, where we're live from the apocalypse. We're week three into now in the apocalypse. The population is low, but the hopes are higher than ever. I'm in the studio today with my boy Joe, as well as Beth, who's here to do the traffic and the weather. How are we doing today?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. It's been a long few weeks.
It has been a long few weeks.
You know, I started to get tired of the constant hurricanes and zombie attacks and alien invasions, but...
It's been a busy one, hasn't it? This whole apocalypse scenario.
It's just been one thing after another, to be frank with you.
You can't escape it anywhere.
No, everywhere you turn, everywhere you look, something else is happening.
So people have messaged in today with a few questions.
Oh,
obviously,
okay.
The other fellow apocalypse dwellers, is there a name for them? People going for the apocalypse? Sufferers, maybe?
Well, I've called to call them the Apoca Kids.
Apoca Kids?
Yeah. It's like, the, you know, there's like Gen X, Gen Z, Boomers. It's like the Apoca Kids.
Apoca
it's like
Kids.
The next generation.
3 weeks in, and we already have the...
I mean, there's been a bit of a baby boom, to be fair, because, you know, with that massive drop in the population...
We need it.
You know, last Wednesday.
I mean...
Everyone's just started going for it.
Before long, we're going to be running out of, like, bread, and we need those kids to be...
You've still got some bread.
I have.
That's impressive.
I know.
Where did you find bread?
That's my secret, Joe. I can't be telling you that. I'm going to be stealing it from me.
Well,
you know, with
watch
all the,
out.
All the laws, you know, no longer a thing. I don't know what you could do.
I'd watch your back if I were you.
I am watching it.
Yeah.
Trust me. Anyway, yeah. So moving on. So a few questions have been sent in by lovely people by Pigeon, because that's the only way we can actually travel now. Because, you know,
lovely.
With the internet dying and being exploded, you know what it's like. Sally from Woodstock has asked, what's your favourite post-apocalyptic snack after a long night of purging?
Oh, you know, what are they called? The Belvita breakfast biscuits. Other biscuits are available.
They do last
very
long.
They're not really anymore because...
Limited item.
Limited items. But yeah, I mean, they're a bit stale, but, you know, it's got a good crunch to it, unlike most of the food.
There's only so much you can really ask for in these dying times. Literally, that's a...
It's very witty.
That was a pun. During these dying times, there's only so much you can ask for. And Belvita breakfast biscuits do. Yes, I like it when you've eaten all your Belvita breakfast biscuits and you get stuck in your teeth.
A little snack for later.
It's another snack for dinner. Yeah, you could probably... If you have a biscuit at breakfast, lunch and dinner, and you get afters in the evening as well... Nothing better than a late night sucking your teeth when you can't sleep as well, just the screams of the many people.
I mean, even like when you've got earmuffs, you know, earplugs, nothing does it. Nothing can keep the screams out. It's insane.
It's crazy. Thank you for answering, sorry, Joe. And
what's yours? I should ask.
Thank you for. I was just about to to say
you?
Mine.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, my favorite. Post-apocalyptic snack, Joe.
Go ahead.
You're really getting on my nerves today. You better watch your back.
I can't wash my back. There's no soap left.
I said watch. Is chopped tomatoes, tins of them.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I used to prefer real tomatoes, but you know, if
it's
tins
only
is
so
what
much.
We got, tins is what we got.
You know, it gets to a point in the apocalypse where you think, what could I realistically have? And what I like to say is that if you close your eyes and keep chewing, yeah, imagine you're doing it now. There we go. Up and down. You,
I'm
pretend
really
you're
getting the wateriness of the tomatoes coming through.
See, if you just pretend that they're seasoning, what are you tasting, Joe? What are you tasting?
A little hint of paprika.
Paprika?
Yeah.
Yeah?
That's really nice,
See,
actually.
I taste basil. When I think of my tomatoes.
That's a classic.
Sometimes I don't know whether I'm eating tomatoes or just my own saliva. It's gotten to that point. It's kind of my go-to, is that you close your eyes, you chew, you imagine, and you forget that you're eating. And then? Satisfaction.
Well.
Yeah, that's how I get through it. It's the little things in the apocalypse.
It is. It has got to be the little things that carry you through, because there isn't much... hope left, to be honest.
There isn't. Beth, do you have a favourite post-apocalyptic snack?
Well, while you eat tomato like from tins, I prefer tomato paste. You can kind of just like put on a stove and just like...
It lasts forever as well.
Yeah.
Does it really?
Yeah, it does.
I'll have to stock up on that then.
Well, I'm not
sure.
It has
multi-purposes. because you can use it to paint. You can use it to clean. It gives you that, like, fruity smell.
What are you painting in the apocalypse?
It just keeps you occupied.
I guess you need to pass the time.
Yeah. Do you remember when our biggest concern was COVID and everyone, like, took up a hobby and, like, some people were painting, some people were making banana bread?
I know.
I guess it's similar to that, except much, much worse.
Yeah, I mean, now 3 years later, and look at us, you know?
I mean, I certainly wouldn't have thought this is where we would be 3 years after COVID.
Yeah, but... painting with tomato paste. I mean, who would have thought? But, yeah, you looking forward to the show today, Joe?
I am. We've got some great segments lined up coming later on in the show.
Going to try and cheer up the people of this awful time.
You know, when there's no hope left, what more could you ask for than URY? You know, it's the one thing that keeps
the last radio station still running as well.
On Earth.
On Earth.
As far as we know. I mean, we've had very little contacts from off of the island.
It is quite funny how we're the last radio station, but we still only have 5 viewers. And I can't tell. It's either between the lack of population or...
I think it's just the lack of popularity of our show.
Yeah, I can't... I feel like we still have the same 5 viewers. Or, sorry, listeners, shall I say.
Yeah, I mean, who's viewing this?
Yeah.
I mean, we've got the cameras in today to document for, future generations, should there be any.
Probably robots.
Well, if that's what it comes to...
We can only hope.
Yeah.
Wouldn't the robots make the apocalypse worse, though?
That's the thing. People have been saying, have the robots caused the apocalypse?
It's everyone owning
Alexa. That's an excellent question.
Yeah. You know, I ask myself that every day. I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I don't want to publicise that live on air. But I have heard some chatter.
Okay.
Through the grapevine.
Let's hold off on that chatter for now.
Of course.
We're going to go to a song very quickly.
I'd love to hear that.
We'll swing back around to Beth with the weather, and then we'll come back to your conspiracy
theories.
Wonderful.
What song we listen to?
So first up, we've got London Calling by The Clash.
Wonderful.
You know, it's almost as though way back in 79, The Clash almost predicted this whole deal.
This whole fiasco.
Yeah. So
let's hear it.
Let's see what they got to say about it. Let me fade up the track.
Almost forgot how to do it.
This is London Calling by The Clash.
Hey you, you're listening to URY.
And welcome back to Alive from the Apocalypse, where we are live from the
Apocalypse.
Did you
just say Alive? Because that kind of works.
That's the name of the show.
We've been having the show for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And we've
Have you not picked up on that?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, it says it on the board behind you.
We've been doing this every day. Stuck in the studio for 3 days.
3 days, three weeks.
3 weeks.
We've been here a while.
It's been 3 weeks.
It's been a long time. Do you remember when we first fled London back then?
That was crazy. And we had that stupid idea of, let's run a radio show. How crazy would that be?
And, you know, well, this was when the internet was still functioning, of course. You know,
of course.
That didn't break down for another few days. You know, and we're like, where's there a radio? Where's there a radio? Having a quick Google.
URY.
Weirdly enough, it was the only one still left at that
point. The only one who would take us as well. BBC hated the idea. I mean...
Well, we don't talk about them anymore, do we?
Of course not.
No.
R.I.P.?
No. R.I.P. indeed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, London. What's happened to it now, then?
Well, it depends which part of London you're talking about. Of course, you weren't originally even from London. You were from Essex. The ends of Essex.
Debatable.
Well, that's totally submerged in water
of course.
At this point. It's been taken over by the Mer people. Do you remember Atlantis?
Yeah. Crazy concept.
Yeah. Who thought that would resurface and the mermen would invade Essex of all places?
I mean, to be fair, I could kind of predict it and see it coming. It's just the fact they did it so fast.
It was just like that. Overnight.
Overnight.
Went from
mer people.
Yeah.
Strange.
Yeah.
Very strange. The thing is I just don't understand how it's happened so fast. And it's a shame because I had quite a lot of friends from London because, you know, being from London.
Mm-hmm. Essex.
No need to bring it up. We don't talk about Essex. And it's...
Well, not anymore, anyway.
Well, no, of course not. It is the apocalypse. But, yeah, just let us know. Give us a little ring if you're from London, because genuinely we need to know.
Yeah.
Because we haven't heard from anyone in ages.
No. Well, last I heard was that Big Ben was on fire. And I don't mean the clock. I just mean our mate, Ben. He's really tall.
Yeah. Poor Ben. And then I've heard... I mean, I thought Big Ben was always a rocket.
Really?
I always thought that.
Did you know some people tried to actually... This was before the apocalypse. Some people tried to get Big Ben elected to be Prime Minister.
He would have done a good job.
I think he would have been a great guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What a clock.
What a clock.
Anyway, is it...
Oh, it's the bell, isn't it? Well, it was the bell.
Was the bell. God. Do you remember his last chime? That was cute.
Well, if you can call it a chime, it sounded more like a scream. Who knew a clock could scream?
Yeah. It's more like a cat kind of falling down a stairs. A stairs? The stairs.
Yeah, the big stairs, which also, you know, got built in London days before the apocalypse.
And then into hell, where at the end of the stairs it kind of opened up a bit.
Well, who knew that it was, when they were building the stairs, who knew they were going to descend to hell? Like, I don't think they would have got planning permission if they'd, you know,
it's a stairway to hell. It is a stairway to hell. Mm-hmm. It's crazy. And it's in London as well. Who would have thought?
Certainly not me. Anyway, let's quickly go over to the weather with Beth. Beth, what's the weather looking like across the country today?
Well, as you said, there's been a lot of flooding in London. The weather in England has completely switched. The south is now freezing, which has really helped the water crisis, while the north is now heating up.
Interesting.
It's quite the sauna. It's made what people have to wear in different places quite difficult, and it's made transport quite hard too. But everyone's adapting. The weather, since it's raining less here, trains are running on time. However, buses have this kind of rule that they can't be early because then they get fired. So this really high turnover of bus drivers, it's not actually because the zombies were targeting them and eating them. It's just because they keep getting fired.
Interesting. Joe, I never thought I'd see someone from Yorkshire wear flip-flops, and here we are.
Well, I mean, other than yourself.
Of course.
Well, I suppose you're not from Yorkshire, we're just here.
Yeah.
Also, he kind of prefers Crocs. It's like the squelch they
thing.
Make when he's back in
Essex. Great for the apocalypse, when you're walking
really?
Over... I can't really say it off camera rules, but when you're walking over the things...
yeah,
it's,
I mean...
Yeah, it's quite hard, and obviously Crocs... resistant to water, along with other liquids.
It's just a shame that they've got the holes in, I suppose.
It gets a bit squelchy.
Mm-hmm.
But do you know what? If you're tolerant, you can put up with it.
Well,
anyway,
I suppose that's the most important thing.
I got another question in.
Go ahead.
From Pigeon.
Via Pigeon?
Via
or
Pigeon.
Or was it a Pigeon that sent this question in?
It's just a person called Pigeon.
Amazing.
I mean, everyone has apocalypse nicknames now, don't they?
Yeah, what's yours?
Pavement.
That's
because I was found on the pavement.
Because you get walked all over.
Oh, thanks. Classic.
Yeah.
Classic quip from a toilet seat. Is that what they call you these days, or have you taken?
Yeah, no, that is what they call me.
Oh,
I.
You haven't changed it.
It's because
no.
He smells like
no.
one.
No, that was pre-apocalypse as well.
Yeah. I thought you were a quad bike at one point.
That was just a phase.
Just a phase.
You know, you got to try some things out.
Yeah.
Quad biking just didn't quite work out for me.
Of course.
It was when I managed to lose both of my arms. That it kind of all fell apart for me. Luckily, I did manage to find them later on. I just mislaid them when I went out for a quad bike.
And when you put them on the wrong way around as well, that was hilarious. That was a time. We had some great, crazy nights in the studio when you had your arms on the wrong way around. The things you can do. It's
some impressive things you can do. Anyway, we'll move on from that because, again, Ofcom rules.
Classic. Oh, wait, sorry, Beth, what's your apocalypse nickname?
That's what I was just going to ask.
Bumblebee.
Oh,
interesting.
That's nice.
Because I have a really sharp sting when I'm collecting those, like, last rations that
yeah.
you have to fight for.
I don't know. I'd probably say you're, personally, for me, something kind of like Gecko.
Gecko?
Gecko, or what's another good apocalypse nickname? There's so many of these days.
Is it kind of like I make a sound similar to them?
Yeah, kind of.
Like Dead Rabbit's Foot.
Dead Rabbit's Foot is good. It's lucky as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Lucky,
you
lucky.
Know, it's kind of grim, which is what you need in the apocalypse. Something that shows that you're
yeah.
gritty, you're willing to survive.
Yeah.
But has a bit of meaning behind it.
Yeah, I don't know. That, again, send us in your apocalypse nicknames, not only because we want to know them, but also we want to know who's actually alive. So
yeah, let us know if you're still kicking.
Like. And also, talking about getting in touch, what did you miss about the world before the apocalypse happened all those 3 weeks ago?
You know, it's the little things.
Of course.
It's stuff like being able to pick up my toothbrush without having to check all of the bristles first.
That is true.
You know,
I've missed that.
It was
such a good
so
feeling.
So simple. You could just brush your teeth without a care in the world.
Go freestyle, as
exactly.
they say.
Exactly. Yeah, you know. What about you, Max? What What sticks out?
God, I...
Oh, sorry. Pavement.
Thank you. Do you know what? It's the things like Aunt Bessie's, you know, where have they gone? Food. I miss food.
Real food.
Specific, no, frozen food.
Frozen food?
Yeah, it's everyone's stolen it, even though none of the freezers works. It's quite...
Well, it's a nightmare, particularly up here in the north, where, as Beth was telling us, it's an absolute sauna outside.
Before, you could leave your Aunt Bessie's Yorkshire pudding, just on the street, and they'd be fine. Now, as it's baking hot,
yeah,
you can't do that anymore. They're already cooked, and they go out of date. It's crazy.
I mean, it was great for the first couple of days. Like, you could just cook stuff, you know, didn't need to turn the oven on. I mean, yeah, you couldn't turn the oven on. That was part of it. But you could just pop stuff outside.
Of course.
But then suddenly, with all the fresh food gone...
No one likes a sweaty and stale Yorkshire pudding.
There is nothing worse. Sweaty is the last thing I want my Yorkshire puddings to be.
It is quite funny, though, looking at the South and saying, you're damp now, you know, the dampness. Who knows?
I feel like the South always had a bit of a damp aura, though.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just kind of fate that it's turned out to be literal now as well.
Yeah. Anything else you miss about the before apocalypse, pre-apocalypse?
You know, like we were saying before, it's stuff as simple as, you know, just being able to close your eyes at night and not just see the faces of all of the loved ones who you've seen perish.
That
you know, and to be able to get some sleep without hearing the howling and the screams and the shrieks and goodness knows what else that happens outside my window. And I mean, a lot of that is just you kind of
that is me
hanging outside trying to get me to let you into my house.
Yeah.
But we all know what happens to you at night, so it's not happening.
I miss trampoline parks.
Trampoline parks?
Yeah. They were fun, you know, good bit of fitness.
I forgot they were even a thing.
Yeah, I forgot as well. You know, good
the
bit of fun.
The strong winds make them quite hard nowadays.
Especially with the roofs have all been blown off, so it's kind of a free-for-all. Great stakeout place if you're ever looking for a little staycation, stay overnight, a bit of change of scenery, as they say, when you still have to fight off the zombies and the hordes of people.
Make sure you're wearing shoes, because those, like, that trampoline gets really hot.
It's not good.
Pretty.
Yeah, it's like you probably fry an egg on there. Also, talking about trampoline parks, do you know who's been spotted at one recently?
Who?
Gemma Collins.
Gemma Collins?
Yeah, in the apocalypse.
I did not realise Gemma Collins was still around.
I didn't know.
I heard she'd gone first.
I couldn't put money on that. But, you know, with Essex going underwater, she had to evacuate. And where better to go than up north when it's all sunny? I think she's hanging out in Edinburgh, doing a great time.
Oh, lovely.
What other celebrities are you happy about making their comeback during the apocalypse?
Oh, well, you know, I never thought I'd see the day where Simon Cowell got a new reality show on television again.
Incredible.
I mean, we say television. It's not really television, is it? But, you know, I'm glad that he's making a comeback. I was never a fan of him before.
Yeah.
But the way he's kind of shaking things up, you know.
Yeah.
Next Top Werewolf, real hit.
Beth, you got a bit of information about this.
No, I'm so sick of it. You want to talk about things you miss from pre-apocalypse? I wish shows would go back to actually being creative. Everything is a reality show now. It's so annoying.
It's easy.
The Walking Dead's new season. No, I don't need to see real zombies. They've renewed Daybreak, another zombie show. Everything supernatural is now. No, who needs VFX? Who needs animators? We can just find some cursed thing on the street.
It has ruined the film industry,
It's
actually.
Gotten lazy. A bunch of graphic designers have gone out. And makeup designers. Just get a real zombie. Do it legit. And
exactly.
It's a shame. It's a real shame.
It's killing an entire industry. And it's devastating to see.
Oh, do you know who else has made a massive comeback? Macaulay Culkin.
Has he? I hadn't
massive
heard that.
He's brought out a new line of clothes. And Beth, I think you have a bit more information about this new line of clothes.
Yeah. Basically, there's a massive boom in apocalypse chic. And just bohemian styles of people who were like choosing to ignore and just feel the positive vibes that the apocalypse has brought them.
Interesting.
He's really capitalized on that kind of audience of like people just want to look good. We're running out of like water to shower with. There's definitely no soap. We're so lucky to have a diffuser in the studio.
I mean, honestly, Joe's stench after 3 days, let alone 3 weeks.
I mean, let's just be glad that the listeners at home you know, can't smell it.
This is not Smell-O-Vision. This is not like Spy Kids 5. That's come out last year.
Well, do you remember when they did Spy Kids 4D?
That was crazy.
Yeah.
Back when it was just scratch and smell.
Do you remember when you went to the cinema to see zombies in 4D and now...
Zombies come to your house in 4D. It's real life.
What is 4D? What's 5D then?
Well, I suppose the fifth dimension is that thing that opened up below Manchester.
That's true.
And all of the demons crawled out from.
I mean, if that happened pre-apocalypse, that would have been crazy for cinema.
It would. And now it's just like, oh, another thing. Oh, yeah, all right, Manchester, you want to be in the in crowd too?
We get it, you're special.
Yeah, all right.
Classic Manchester. Yeah.
Oh, best city in the country. Yeah, right.
Yeah, just because you have 5D doesn't mean anything.
No.
Of course not.
Nightmare.
Well, in York, well, God, what are we like? I mean, when I say God, I literally mean God.
Yeah, descended from the heavens.
Crazy.
Who thought that, you know...
I mean, we do have the Minster. That was probably...
Yeah, but wasn't that overtaken by, like, that cult?
True.
I forgot about that.
I did forget about that. Do you know, it's getting to the time now where I'm just forgetting about everything that's happened because of how crazy it's been.
There's too much to keep track of.
Yeah.
Really.
Too much.
It's just every day it seems like there's another thing going on.
Like Stacey Solomon, talking about celebrities. Sorry, segueing back onto that.
Yeah.
The new line of baby clothes with Mother Care. Any new news on that?
Yeah, they're selling riot shields. Obviously, with zombies, you get zombie babies. So you need to keep your own babies safe. So they've got all these different brands. You can get them personalised based on what games your kids like. People were so like objecting to like video games because they were too violent, but now it's great training.
Great preparation.
So Mothercare have released stuff for kids as well as pregnant women. And then you've got just general fashion companies. They're releasing shields,
like
swords.
Gap. Who would have thought the Gap?
I never thought I'd see the day when the Gap made a come gap. Come back.
Come.
The Gap has come back.
The Gap has come back. Yeah. They've closed the Gap.
They certainly have. They've closed a gap in the market.
Yeah. Talk about minding the gap. Sorry. I thought that was a great segue there. The Tube in
what
London.
About it?
The Tube people. Have you not heard about this?
No.
Yeah, the Tube people going around London.
No way.
So, basically what's happened is with London, half it underwater, obviously, people have started to result in going back to the Tubes, much like during the World Wars.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, who would have thought? There's a whole society going on down there. It's literally, they're calling it Camden 2.0. Camden 2.0.
Well, I was never a fan of Camden 1.0, so must be an upgrade.
It must be an upgrade. Also, it's so many advantages about being underground. I mean, it's no sunlight, of course.
Well, I mean, it's not so much a problem down there. Big benefit for us, being able to go underground in the north to get away from those... heat waves, but I suppose it's warmer underground too down south.
Yeah, so. Of course. It's keeping warmth, you know, with the cold weather comes snow, and of course, with their cars, don't really work in cold weather.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't, you know, who would have thought electric cars?
I have a question about these like underground societies.
Mm-hmm.
Just looping back to your conspiracy theories thing, we've always had this idea of lizard people.
Oh, now I've heard Northumbria.
What about Northumbria?
Reports of lizard people.
No.
But not from the apocalypse. Evolution.
Is this humans rising to meet the apocalypse?
Anything on the lizard people, Beth?
Well, I was just curious, because how do we know that it's, like, new in Camden and it's not always been there?
Yeah.
I mean, people have always thought that those higher-ups had like that little bit of yellow over their eyes.
Of course. Of course.
So as opposed to you know, the lizard people just emerging, they've always been underground, and we're going underground to join them.
Yeah.
Well,
interesting.
On that note, I think it's time for another song.
I got a message in just saying we need another song.
Excellent. Well, this is very apt. Going Underground by The Jam.
Wonderful. Whoa, that was crazy. That was The Underground by...
It's Going Underground by The Jam.
I miss jam so much. Do you know what crumpets taste like without jam?
Not very nice.
Crumpets. Do you know what crumpets taste like?
Crumpets.
Gravel.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I can't remember the last time I had a crumpet.
I can't tell if they're out of date or not. Probably.
But they must be at this point. Surely they're not making new crumpets anymore.
I've heard that people have been started making like bread and other savoury items into weapons. They're quite good at carving stuff.
Oh, okay.
You get a sharp stone, sharpen them.
And sharpen a baguette into, what, like a lance or something, I suppose?
I've heard that bread sports.
We should bread
bring,
sports?
Bread sports. We should bring that.
Yes, of
thing.
Course. The, they don't
Javelin.
Call it pole vaulting anymore, do they? It's baguette vaulting.
Baguette vaulting?
Yeah, that's a good
Fencing,
one.
Fencing.
Yeah.
Croissant. I know.
Croissant throwing. That's like the same as when they used to do shot put. It's just because the croissants have got so like
Surely it's
hard
more of a sourdough. Sourdough size for a shot put, would you think? Discus?
Can you find
Tortilla?
Some, can you find some sourdough?
Sourdough, absolutely not.
Well, there you go then.
That's a fair point.
Where there's an abundance of croissants. For some reason, the French started shipping them over last week.
Are the French even going for the apocalypse?
Well, I don't know.
I mean, there
perhaps
are
that
few...
was their idea of relief, just sending loads of stale old croissants.
They're a few weeks behind, so
well,
who knows?
French are always a few weeks behind.
I mean, I wish
they?
We could go to our outside broadcast, to our little off-island reporter, little Lorcan in Ireland, but unfortunately we haven't heard from him in a few days.
No, it's sad.
No idea what's happened.
If you are out there, please do get in touch, because we're starting to get worried.
Yeah, and we miss our reports from Ireland. I mean, the Guinness levels have dropped. We're missing it here.
Yeah. I mean, it was never quite the same here anyway. But
of course not. I mean, we've started making our own alcohol to get by.
Need some home brewing.
Home brewing. What have you brewed recently, actually, Joe?
Talking like we were earlier about tomato paste, I've started using it to make a really nice kind of... you kind of ferment it and it kind of turns into a wine. It's like, instead of... It's got tomato-y undertones, you know?
That sounds like ketchup.
It's fermented ketchup.
Fermented ketchup.
Yeah.
I think you have a business there, Joe.
I hope so.
Do you think there's businesses happening around? Obviously, there's not much going on in Europe.
Well, a few things have sprung up, actually, haven't they?
Really?
Yeah. I mean, we were talking earlier about kind of, you know, the clotheslines that have started coming through.
I mean, I know a lot of people benefited quite a lot off the first week of the apocalypse.
Yeah.
You know, selling these zombie guards and, you know, also zombie makeup. The makeup industry has gone boom.
Yeah.
I mean, is it L'Oreal Paris? It's changed the name to L'Oreal London.
Yep.
Obviously, they get the London look, which is now
a zombie. Yeah.
So
don't forget the mer people. They have a very distinct set of style that people are like going crazy for.
Like the gills.
Well, I think this is something that people aren't talking enough about. It's not just the, you know, the survivors, the apoca kids that are, you know, managing to, you know, still find ways to get on with life.
Of course.
You know, there's all of these new races and, you know, alien species and...
Aliens.
And demons, you know.
Zombies,
the whole deal,
shindig.
Whole
yeah.
shebang. You know, that are, you know, really finding gaps in the human market with things that we've been wanting for years, but not knowing we wanted, like the gills, you know.
Gills are really helpful.
Yeah.
I've been thinking I'd get myself a pair of gills, actually.
You know, until the zombies came out, who knew that brains tasted so good?
Yeah.
Like, they've become a bit of a delicacy, actually, around here.
Are you trying to tell us something, Joe?
No.
Okay.
But, you know, like they say, crocodile tastes like chicken.
Are you saying...
I've heard, through the grapevine, that right. brains taste like lamb.
Really?
Yeah.
I wouldn't
kind
have...
of a bit chewier.
Yeah?
Is
this why we've been keeping you the other side of the studio this whole time?
Well, I mean, you can't see under the table, but... You know, my leg is chained to the desk.
I forgot we'd done that again. I keep forgetting stuff that we've done. It's been so long. That's why you smell so bad. Joe, you should have said.
Not the only reason, is it?
But, of course.
I mean, it's up there.
Yeah, I did forget to supply you with, you know, your nappies and everything else after, you know.
It was a real mess over here.
Week two, I can imagine. Anyway, so actually, that's something I do miss. I miss a clean-smelling Joe and a clean-smelling studio, apart from our room diffuser that we got our side of the table. Mm. What do you miss about the apocalypse? Oh, I mean, sorry, what do you miss about the first week?
The first week.
How did you spend it?
After we'd kind of managed to get out of London.
Of course.
You know, kind of went home to Nottingham for a couple of days, just check on my family.
Cup of tea.
Yeah, I mean, Nottingham, I don't know if you've heard, there wasn't anything left. It kind of there was a sinkhole.
Yeah.
Kind of got swallowed up by the earth. But it's left a really nice desert.
Great holiday location.
Exactly. You know, I had a wonderful week in the sun, got a suntan, made loads of new friends. You know when you
was
like
it
kind
all inclusive?
Of, it was,
oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
There were weirdly like people selling cocktails and all sorts.
My cocktails mean like Magners and
yeah.
What other WKD? What
yeah. Oh, here? Love a WKD.
WKD in the sun.
Exactly. It was glorious. Weirdly enough, kind of all of that start. There wasn't a lot there, and then I found this like weird cactus, and tried some of that, and all of a sudden, you know, kind of the whole world seemed to open up, and this resort grew out of the ground, and it was great.
That's strange for a cactus to grow that fast.
It wasn't the cactus. It was I kind of ate the cactus, and then all of a sudden, you know, this 5-star resort emerged.
Interesting. I mean, I spent my
no,
first
I couldn't think
week.
That it could have been a hallucination.
It could have. Now you say it. So, or I mean, a lot of things have happened. I mean, obviously, with 5D happening in Manchester.
Well,
who could have predicted that? And lizard people. Yeah.
Honestly, I mean, the other thing, you know, we talk about 5D, but I think the thing that's more impressive is 1D finally got back together. Well, I mean,
yeah,
we say
yes.
That.
I mean, two of them are zombies.
Get back together. Yeah.
Yeah. I think they just were going to them naturally because of brains, obviously.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Then, obviously, Louis being a merman now.
Yes.
He's come out and said that he's now a merman.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very brave of him.
Yeah.
It makes for really good live shows. Just like
great
having that range,
yeah.
Great representation of like.
Exactly.
Harry Styles hasn't changed.
No, well, I mean, he doesn't need to. He's already great representation as it is.
Yeah, I mean, what about their new album coming out? Any news on the new album? Any titles? Any singles?
They've released 3 singles so far.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And they've also done a special concert where none of the songs. It supposedly has the entire album's catalogue in there, but I'm still like. Obviously, the internet's down.
Yeah.
So it's quite hard to find those illegal recordings.
I mean, Lorcan was supposed to be there, but
yeah.
We haven't heard from him.
Who?
Lorcan. Our Irish reporter.
Oh, yeah, him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Supposed to be there.
What happened to him, I wonder.
Have you heard of a new band emerging called Sinkhole?
Oh, yeah. No, they were actually from... Well, it's not Nottingham anymore, is it? But they were from Nottingham.
I mean, it's 3 members of Biffy Clyro.
Mm-hmm.
A random guy from Nottingham. It also has a old member of URY, Matt the Ward Perkins.
No way.
Yeah, part of Sinkhole.
Who would
he's
have guessed?
There. That's good.
Yeah, he's still out there. He's making a name for himself. He's really, you know, taking this apocalypse in his stride. Learnt bass guitar.
Well, you know, bass is like the sound industry. You always need a bassist.
Exactly. And apparently they're doing a joint song with KSI, who's still kicking about.
No way.
Yeah, Sinkhole x KSI. It's going to be great. Coming out in just a few days. Well, we don't know until the pigeon gets to us.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of weird that music has managed to keep going because obviously the radio's still here. So
yeah.
It's kind
of radio is
its
one
roots.
Of the few institutions left. I suppose it's the analog nature of it. You know, you can just tune in if you've still got one.
Oh, it's
I
fantastic.
Mean, it's kind of sad because obviously the great thing about music is how it can be used in other mediums, and dance doesn't exactly work on the radio, but we make
no.
Do.
Well,
no.
I mean, it doesn't work on TV particularly either anymore, given
no.
There isn't TV.
Yeah, it's such a shame. Who would have thought TV would have gone? I would have predicted it'd be radio. And look at us now. Look
here we are.
At us now.
Everyone said radio is a dying institution. Boy, we proved them wrong.
Yeah, look at this. This is crazy.
Yeah.
So, yeah, no, I spent my first week in the apocalypse actually listening to radio.
Yeah.
When it was still on.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, the limited amount of radio stations.
Yeah, shrinking number. I
Mary
suppose.
Berry had a great show.
Yeah,
yeah. Mary Berry's Apocalypse Delights.
Ooh.
Yeah, a little baking show out of the last ones of her rations. It was quite howling near the end. I mean, when she just ate a whole bag of flour, that was really odd. Strange to listen to as well because you could kind of just hear like a. It's quite thick flour, and I guess Mary Berry, bless her. Yeah, she's done well, and she's still going.
She's still going?
Yeah, I've heard through the grapevine.
It's good to hear. I was worried after she ate a whole bag of flour that she might not have made it.
I mean, you would have... I mean, any way you can survive, really. It's
she
crazy.
She probably made quite a lot of money out of it, which could then, like, help her recover.
Yeah, publicity stunt, as they say.
True, get a name out there again.
Of course.
Yeah.
I mean, she needs to. New cookbook coming out, coming soon.
Yeah?
Yeah, she actually wrote it all. Only one copy. Of course, not much paper.
She's just passing it around.
Yeah, it's done all on the back of old files and reports from a police station. So,
wow.
On one, it's a two-sided book. You can read it one way and read about a file case about God, what was the case? It was an old one about mm-hmm. someone. Something to do with fraud during the apocalypse.
So this fairly recent then, back when the police were still a thing.
Yeah, I think it was Edwin Barnes.
Edwin,
yeah.
Oh.
Old face. So you can read about that report on one mm-hmm. side. Flip it over, Mary Berry's new cookbook.
She kind of missed out on a trick, because there's been a lot of like bakery related crime. She could have done it like themed, where if she just got all of the back was just stuff like she was like burning down buildings because of bread.
Yeah.
Or like people who've stolen cupcakes, but she just went for fraud.
I mean, there's when you break into a police station, where I think she was camping out when she did the whole flower incident.
You would assume so.
Yeah. There's not much selection you can really have. Apparently, they locked her up after that.
Oh.
Yeah, in the holding cell.
Oh.
Mary Berry got arrested in the apocalypse.
No way.
Who would have thought? Also,
well, I mean, her radio show was a crime.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. So, yeah, I spent that listening. I waited in a pub for probably about 3 days. That was
lovely.
Great. That was great.
Yeah.
A little pub called the Winchester, just outside London.
Oh.
Yeah, great pub. And then I moved on up here to find some of the sun and also the radio. Talking about things to do with the apocalypse, what do you like about the apocalypse? What's new?
Well, so, you know, as you know, I've been trying to find time to work on my memoirs for a while.
Of course.
And all of a sudden, with the collapse of civilization, I've got time to do that.
I heard you have a new poetry book coming out, Joe.
A new what book?
New poetry book. Oh, sorry,
new
toilet seat.
Yes.
Toilet seat? Sorry.
Yeah. It's called Toilet Seat's Guide to the Apocalypse.
Okay.
A collection of short stories and slam poetry.
Slam poetry?
Yes.
Do you want to give us an example reading?
I've managed to get some charge back in my phone.
Did you rub it really hard?
Well, it's solar panels.
Of course.
You know,
who would have thought solar power's the way to go?
Managed to jerry-rig something together. So, if you just give me a minute.
I'm giving you a minute.
Here we go. I've got to do this quickly because my phone might die.
Of course.
Darkness.
That was
light.
Whoa.
Screams. Ah! That's it.
There's so much emotion in that.
I'm surprised.
It's not all we got either. There are more that we've been working on.
Was my interruption part of the poem?
Yeah, it was actually.
Is that what you wanted?
It was.
Do you wait
you
for someone to
into that?
Do you wait for people to talk and
mm-hmm.
then you?
And then you butt in like the apocalypse did. This is the point.
He just understands the psyche of the reader so intensely and
mm-hmm.
well.
That is Picasso. That
well,
is beautiful.
Yeah.
Is each line on like a? Is each word on a separate line?
It's a different page.
Oh.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
And like I'm not talking one page either. I'm talking a double page spread for each.
Joe, you're an inspiration.
Splash page.
You're an inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
I'm shocked. You're going to go down the history books for that.
You are keeping
well,
kids interested in literature.
Yeah, it's so important.
Someone's got to do it.
Of this whole radioactive incident happening around York, around the outside. You know, when you just get the train in from London, obviously we saw it when we walked past, you see all the nuclear power plants. Who knew that would be a bad thing?
I mean, you know, when they all exploded,
yeah.
It was certainly a shock.
Yeah.
Did you lose anyone in that?
I mean, I lost a few of my toes, but then I grew a couple back because of radiation.
Of course. Yeah. The third arm, which, I mean, you can't see because it's kind of sticking out of my back.
It's not very big, isn't it?
It's not very good. No.
It's kind of
more
big.
Like a finger, but it's still got, like, a hand at the end. It's really odd.
I mean, if you have a back itch, like, I don't have to scratch your back anymore.
No, it's helpful for that.
Especially, yeah, I don't really
get
too close to you.
Kind of get that...
Yeah.
Tough spot to reach.
No, my tortoise grew an extra shell.
Your tortoise grew an extra shell?
Yeah.
How does it even do that? Like, where?
Around the previous shell.
How do you know?
How can you tell? I think I just...
It just looked like a regular shell.
I guess... I think my tortoise might have grown. Again, I can't count the days.
I can't count. That's unrelated to the apocalypse.
Yeah, I was about to say you couldn't do that before.
Never finished maths.
That, and now you can't.
No.
But who cares? It's the apocalypse.
Yeah.
Go have fun.
It doesn't matter.
Go don't.
As
count.
I always say, literature is the way forward.
It is the way forward.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need literature to do that. But do you know what we do need in the apocalypse?
What do we need?
Music to keep us going.
Yes, exactly. Really bizarrely, Pitbull has made a huge resurgence.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean,
really climbing back up through the charts again.
All those like meteor showers, it's probably like reminded people of stuff, just like fireballs in the sky.
Yeah. Well, it's funny you should say that, because that is what has gone straight to number one.
Straight to number one.
Straight to number one.
It's a feel-good song.
It is. It certainly makes me feel good when I hear it.
Raise your spirits during these dying times.
Exactly.
Literally dying times.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Right. Well, let's play this week's latest number one. This is Fireball by Pitbull.
Wonderful.
Featuring John Ryan, apparently.
Is he still popping about?
Not anymore.
Oh, what a shame.
Mr. Worldwide to infinity.
Fireball.
Hey, you. You're listening to URY.
Wow. Talking about fireballs, I think I just saw one pass the window. That was crazy.
That's insane.
Yeah, now that's what you call a beat drop.
It is indeed. When you really get the reverb coming through with the meteors crashing down around you.
Talking about dropping beats, dropping bombs.
Dropping bombs.
What's been going on?
Well, we've just had some reports through that the bombs have started falling.
How did we get that? Was it through the new Facebook?
It was actually, yes.
So I'm not sure if our listeners, all five of them, have heard of what's happened recently, but the Facebook, as in the Facebook, all separate words, has made a reoccurrence. Obviously, people may have heard of, you know, Meta and Facebook made by Zuckerberg.
All stuff of the past.
Something to do with the lizard people, I think they're still using it.
I mean, it was dying before the apocalypse hit.
Classic.
The real casualty of the apocalypse.
Yeah. Do you know what, actually, talking about casualty.
What about it?
Really popular now.
Yeah, well, again, another one that's become a reality TV show.
Yeah, they could just take... I mean, in the first like week or so, they did it Casualty Live, which was an interesting move by...
Yeah, where the studio... Well, not the studio audience, but the like audience at home could vote for who they wanted to save.
That was crazy, man.
That was insane when they were like, okay, we want the surgeon now to cut, you know, through this artery. And it's like, that's... Why are you cutting through arteries? Why is that even an option?
I thought the plot got even crazier when they got that 13-year-old to do the surgery as well.
I mean...
The lab coat was far too big for him.
That was the funniest thing.
Especially when they had to go on each other's shoulders to do it. That was to get a... It's, do you know what? When, as soon as they said to... who would have known? As soon as you said to television, you have... Like, there's no ethics now.
No.
Who would have thought how crazy it could have got?
Well, I mean, sticking to conspiracy theories, Doctor Who predicted all of this. Like...
All of it?
In Christopher Eccleston's era, they showed the future of television being people voting to stay alive. And, I mean, I'm not saying the writers had, like, prophetic... How do you say that? Like,
prophetic fallacy.
Yeah, or, like, just the ability prophetic. To see the future... But now we know everything else weird that's going on, like, and that the lizard people have kind of always been there.
Who knew?
He could have been warning us.
It's like a Black Mirror episode. It's like we're living in a Black Mirror episode.
It's worse than that.
Okay, I'm going to cry. Thanks, Joe. But the Facebook has made a reoccurrence.
Yes, it has. It's a literal book of faces
now. It's now they just pass around a book and they see how many faces they can get in it. Mm-hmm. And do you know how they've been doing it?
How have they been doing it?
So you
it?
Have to kind of like... dunk your head in some kind of mud or ink or whatever you got. I think, what did I use for mine? I think I had some leftover yellow paint when I repainted my shed in week two.
Okay.
Dunk my head in it and you have to smash it really hard against the book. It's a really big book, this. And it creates a perfect outline on your face. Obviously, my nose was broken for a bit. Luckily, I got the witch doctor to sort that out for me.
Yeah.
Good old guy.
Yes.
Yeah. Jeff.
The witch doctor.
Who would have known? His career would have taken him into that route.
Was quite a turn. Very unexpected.
Yeah, Big Jeff. Who would have known? Changed his whole outfit as well. I think the one thing about the apocalypse is that people really show their true colours.
That is true. That is very true.
Yeah.
You get things from people that you never saw it coming.
Exactly. It's like going for the Facebook, because obviously you get to write about yourself. And
yeah.
What's going on.
Make a little profile.
Like looking at your old friends and what they're doing now.
Yeah.
Obviously there's some people in... you know, the Bedallion and all these, like, uprising and doing zombade, all these charities that they've created. And then some people just commit into the chaos.
Yeah.
I mean, my friend ate his page in the Facebook.
He ate his own page?
He was against it. Absolutely against it, yeah.
Well, I guess there are some people that still are against social media, even in this day and age.
I think I just heard someone go into...
Oh, with...
Studio Blue. Is that Alex Towse?
I think it is.
Someone's in Studio Blue. Did you leave the door open again, Joe? Joe.
Possibly.
I've told you about this.
Good to know how Taz is getting on, though, that he's become a zombie.
What's left of him.
In the apocalypse. Yeah.
It's great he doesn't have to wear glasses anymore.
Well, I mean, I suppose you don't need glasses if you don't have eyes.
That is true. Brilliant. Well, at least he's saving money at Specsavers.
He's pressing his face right up against the window now.
That's a great angle. Oh. Hi, Alec. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. Cheers, mate. Stuff like this just doesn't work on the radio. No. And it's a shame you can't show it.
Yeah, it is a real shame that you listeners at home can't see the terrifying vision that is...
Alex Taus.
Well, I mean, I thought it couldn't get any worse.
Same. Nightmare. I mean, should we have a last... report on traffic in the local area before we go.
Yeah, before we play a final song out, and then we'll have to
evacuate because Alex Towers is
trying to break through the window.
Yeah, right. This is getting crazy.
The car industry has really benefited. Though motorways are packed, because you've got the radioactive horses, the zombies, the mer people who've been like captured by the fishermen, then left to kind of dry up on the road. But green energy has boomed in the north because of all the sun. So, you know, cars, solar-powered cars, it's great.
Yeah, it's really good that.
Yeah, great.
Okay.
Great knowledge. Okay, Alex.
Some people really benefited from this, and some people really didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah. This whole zombie... Sorry, Beth. Alex, we get it.
Okay, I think we're going to have to wrap up there. You know, it's been a great show again, guys. Thanks for coming back.
Hopefully we can do it tomorrow.
If the radiation doesn't kill us.
Yeah,
What do you want for dinner? Because I've got 2 pots of beans left.
Ooh, I'll have a pot of beans.
Pot of beans?
Yeah.
Pot of beans.
Close your eyes, imagine the paprika.
Yeah, imagine
Delicious.
That paprika.
Yeah. Okay, anyway. now, this is the real apocalypse, because who would have thought I, on a radio show, would ever actively choose to play Imagine Dragons?
I'm imagining it right now.
Well, you don't have to, it's happening. You know, it just seemed too apt. With the bombs falling, the radiation seeping in.
How could it get any worse?
Well, there's only one way. This is Radioactive by Imagine Dragons. Thanks for listening.